What's going on, guys? We are back with some more MLB The Show 24. Franchise mode with Yor. And yeah, I hinted at a trade last time. Where we'd send Andrew Painter and Josiah Gray for Mackenzie Gore. And Ryan Dean. Yeah, I do like this trade. Who else do we want to trade? No, I think it was the Mariners, yeah. So I think we're going to make them separate trades. Yeah, we're gonna add a Brad Jameson to the 40. Yeah, because yeah, there's definitely some guys that I do want to try out. Who's on the 40, man? Thank you. the first thing I want to do is lock up an Andrew Painter to a 10-year deal. So that's going to cost us around, like, if I can get him for, like, 10.5, yeah, I'll do that. We have $18 million that we can potentially offer him. Okay. How well comfortable do I feel with this rotation? Yeah, a lot of new pitchers. Mag, who last pitched in game 5. And that's filed away. And that's a base hit in the center. And Luis Angel Acuña really broke out in last year's playoffs. That's going to get down. Jesus. What the hell kind of went wrong there? First pitches upstairs for a ball. And that's a base hit into the gap. Both 1-point teammates on the Red Sox. Lux picks it up, one away. or two down. And that's fouled away. Got him looking. Nice pitch from Whitlock. Keeper Ruiz, yeah, we know he's an all-star. Pitches outside. Yeah, this is a guy that really needs to pick up, at least in real life, anyway. That ball's hitting the air. Lux is there. I'm gonna catch one out. Harold Ramirez, two-time All-Star. Got him. Jordan Alvarez takes a strike. Pitches upstairs. That's fouled away. That's up the middle. Acuna picks it up, fires in time. Here's Gavin Lux. And that ball's hit in the air. McCormick makes the catch. Pretty good ride on that one. That's fouled away. House picks it up, fires in time. That's fouled away. And that ball's crushed. Yeah, most of the guys that were here last
for a strike.
Year. And it's 0-1.
Sure, yeah, I'm gonna let them. I'm gonna let the sim handle our bats, but new guys, yeah, I'm gonna use them. Fuck. And my capture card doesn't want to fucking work.
For the pitcher, but this is all about creating more action and speeding up the game, and it's working.
A little bit high, and a count 2-1.
Two balls, one strike.
And that gets the top of the zone for a strike. One way to make a guy real uncomfortable at the plate is pound him inside with good velocity. They're doing that right here.
And that is the inning. One hit in the inning. Welcome back, and they turn to a new arm as we kick off the bottom of the...
Now batting, shortstop, Daniel Squire.
Digging in for the Nationals. And that one
that's fouled away.
Well, all eyes on the double play ball in this spot. No better way to get out of this inning. Swings through that one for strike two. I went through the situation here.
He's number two pitching prospect, number 14 in
ground ball. See if he adjusts on this next pitch.
Swing and a pop up. And the infield fly rule call. So first and second. Ready now for the fifth inning. Here's Christian Arroyo. 0-1 so far. Painter, 23 years old. And they traded for him earlier this year.
Swing that ball's down the line. Gonna be fouled, but Wood makes the catch.
Paul Peraza up next for the Astros. Lifted in the air, right
center.
In the air
to center.
Crow Armstrong moves after it, hauls it in, and there's two away.
Every day during batting practice, these outfielders get about 10 minutes of balls in the gaps. They practice this, and when the game comes, they make the play perfectly.
So the lineup flips over. So next up for Houston, Cody Bellinger. Fastball in for a strike, 0-1. Two down, nobody on, and we're at the top of the fifth. Swing and a high fly ball.
Ball sit high and deep.
That's back there.
Makes the catch.
Three up, three down that time. Home half of the fifth coming up. Is the Astros two. Back now to start the bottom of the.
fifth and taking over on the mound. Oh, no. Michael Wacha.
Still a lot of game left, and this game could go either way. So this is a big opportunity for him to get some important outs and try to help carry this lead into the later innings.
Welcome back as we have a pinch hitter to lead it off. Vaughn Grissom.
And this is a big at bat coming, Boo. Definitely a little added pressure on him here.
The 1-0.
Shot that ball.
Action in the pen down there. Cal Quantrill getting loose out there. Inside, just missed. So definitely a little wild right out of the gate.
Well, it can be a little tough coming from the bullpen mound to this mound, but you've got to find a way to get ahead in the count. Quickly, he has it. We'll see how this at bat turns out.
That one finds the zone. The count is 3-1. Next offer is in for a strike. Good plate appearance.
And he walked him.
There, able to take the walk.
It's tough after falling behind a hitter, two balls and no strikes, but now at least he gets a fresh start against a new batter, but he needs to get back into the strike zone and start pitching with conviction.
Yeah, Wanda a little short.
Ground ball could be two. Pena flips it. They get the force for out number one. Out on the underhand top.
Got what he was looking for in the mound right there, and his infielders took care of business. Great textbook execution between short and second to turn that into two outs.
Harold Ramirez digs in now. One for two. He had an RBI base hit back in the first. And he grounds one to the right side. And it goes just foul.
That's a base hit.
So a runner aboard to start the inning. Here's Jordan Alvarez.
Yeah.
Swing and a miss there.
Zero balls, left strike.
Next offering is in for a strike. The pitch. Just misses without.
He's gone.
It's a good take. Yeah, this one's crushed down the line. Looking. Foul ball.
Well, that ball's hit pretty hard and sure had home run distance, but if you're the pitcher out there on the mound,
he's down looking.
Executed. Just a long strike. Go after him and finish him off.
And now it's Alex Bregman. See the velocity 97 with that fastball. Swings and blasts one deep to left center. That's back there. And it's gone.
Just sneaks over.
That's exactly the pitch he was looking for. Crushes it and hits it out of the ballpark.
And first offering is fouled off. Outside.
That's the ball.
That to right. Wood sizing this one up. He makes
Wood
the grab.
Will make the catch.
Two away.
It's a good recovery, though, after giving up the home run. Not allowing it to stay in the head, but going to work at the next hitter. And a tough one at that.
McCormick stands in now and watches strike one. Right through there for a strike. Two runs across in the inning, and we're in the top half of the sixth.
Gets
and misses, it's a strikeout. Back now for the bottom of the sixth.
But they get two.
Three. Ball four, take the base. Three.
And now, Jeremy Pena. Jameson, back to work. There's a strike.
0-1.
delivers. Hit hard on the ground is short. And they get the leadoff hitter in the seventh.
Now got that. The second.
And stepping in for the Astros, Christian Arroyo. Ground ball right side, Manzardo.
Manzardo will take it.
And two away to start the seventh.
Up next, yeah.
Two outs, base is empty. Next to hit, Oswald Peraza. Right through there for a strike.
There it was. Here it is. Hit it. He gets a take. It's a head and a count.
Just off the inside edge.
One and one.
Center field. Crow Armstrong should have it. And that is that. Nothing doing. We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom.
Get a run.
Back now, as it'll be a pinch hitter to lead off, Jake Myers.
Well, with his speed, he could really make some things happen.
That's the ball.
Close but call a ball, and that is ball one. And he dodges that fastball.
Two up.
Strike one.
Two one.
The pitch.
Got him looking.
And now one away.
Well, this is no secret. That slider is going to be his go-to pitch. Everyone in the ballpark knows it. It's a massive part of his arsenal, and he'll throw it a lot, and in pretty much any count, any situation, and he's going to look to punch guys out as well. I tell you what, the effectiveness of that slider is always a big key for him.
Manzardo snags it for the second out. Looks like it'll be a pinch hitter, Eggy Rosario, trying to get something going for him with two away.
And Rosario drives it down the line.
On his way over.
Kelenic running over, and he'll make the catch.
And foul ground. So remaining in the game defensively, Jake Myers. He'll be out center now after pinch hitting. Lucas Sims gets the ball now. Top nine, and it'll get started with a pinch hitter, Kyle McCann.
For a little insurance here to start the ninth, boot.
Just missed. And that's in there at the knees for a strike. And here it comes. Out to short.
Pryor picks it up, fires in time.
Throws to first. Now one gone in the ninth. There comes the pinch hitter for the Astros, number 70. Look at him start something with one gone. Swag at a pop-up, foul at a play off to the right side. That'll find the stands. And he drops it down the third baseline. Bare hand has to
got him.
It's there, and that's a great play.
Smooth play on the bare hand there at third. That was nice.
On the ground, right side. One to first.
I was like, beats him there.
And the inning is over. Staying in the game on defense, number 35. He'll be the new right field.
Three.
When he never gets old, but it's also important to come out and play with some level of a fear of failure. That's what brings out the best, knowing.
Thank you.
base. And now it's Gavin Lux. 0 for 3 with 3 ground outs. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
Well, this is a critical spot for both the pitcher and the hitter. You can learn a lot about a guy by how he handles these pressure situations.
Left-hand batter waits.
And Lux drives one in the air.
That's back there.
That's going to be over the wall, over the head.
One runs in. A second scores his
and Lux to third.
In there. He's safe.
Well, the ball that should be caught isn't because of a bad angle, bad route to the baseball, and allows a huge run to score late in this ball game.
So the Marlins go with a new arm, Tanner Banks.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their players a chance to fight back into the game.
House
at the plate now. That's ball one. And there's the strike.
Well, that's really the money spot. Down and away, if you can locate that consistently,
it's going to be real tough for hitters to square that up. That's what you love to see relievers do coming out of that bullpen.
That's foul away.
Two outs and a runner at third, and we're at the top of the eighth. Swing, and that ball smashed on the line. Mesa makes the catch,
right there, and that is that.
Bottom eight, welcome back, as we've got a pinch hitter, Nick Allen.
They're running out of time in this game, trying to get something started here.
Now the mound for the Nationals, Roussard Grotterol.
These are the spots where relievers really make a name for themselves, late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
This one in the air, center field. Coming on.
Scott is there.
Now a move being made for a pinch hitter, Garrett Hampson. One out, the base is empty for him. Bunting for a hit, he pops it up. And that's a bunt single. That was placed.
Is that James Wood?
Pinch hitter, Dominic Smith. Runner on first and one down for him.
What the fuck is James Wood catching?
Now into the game.
Especially when we have another one.
He takes over behind the plate. Little chopper rolls foul.
Please.
Got him!
Very questionable steal attempt right there. You're down by two runs. Tying runs at the plate. Your run is so important. You have to be smarter than that. It can't be playing around in this situation. Trust the guy at the plate with one swing to tie it up. That right there could be very costly.
Wouldn't chase that time. The Nats up by two. Here the bottom half of the eighth inning.
God.
Slider struck him out. So we're
rather all looking out in
Garrett Hampson.
4-4, take your base. 3.
What the fuck is Jose Trevino doing out there?
Baseman Ty France on a pitch now for the Nationals. Pete Fairbanks.
I can't imagine any save is an easy one. You're holding a small lead on the scoreboard, and you know those hitters are going to give you the best at bats they can. So it's always high stress. Let's see what he's got here to try and close it out.
Swinging a foul straight
Pete
back.
Fairbanks acquired.
This is a guy that can be frustrating for pitchers because he fouls off so many pitches and grinds out the at-bat. I'm sure there's some times where a pitcher would rather just give up a first pitch single that have to waste six or seven pitches on one hit.
Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball.
Now he's desperately looking for that swing and miss. He's going to have to just change speeds a little bit, try to move it around, create just a little bit of illusion at the end.
Got him looking. Triple digits.
I don't think he was taking it, thinking it might be a called ball or anything. I just think he was flat out frozen. Did not expect that location, in my opinion.
This one popped up.
Vaughn's there, and he'll make the catch.
They got it for out number two. A couple of pitches and a quick out. So it's their last chance in this one.
Rondo Smokio.
And first offering is fouled off. Kicks and deals. Swinging a foul back. That's out of play. Fairbanks is just one strike.
Got him!
And a swing and a miss, and that is the ball game.
Well, this is a fun game all the way around. We saw plenty of action. 12 runs total on the board, but a pretty close finish at the end.
New inning getting started. Stepping in, Nick York. He's 0-1. First pitch swinging.
She can live up in the zone all game if guys will chase it. That's just too much velocity. They're just going to look down in the zone.
Fires in a fastball at 95.
Really going after him here. All fastballs to get ahead in the count.
And that just misses.
Man, oh man, I don't know how you take that pitch. That's as close as it gets.
The 2-2 now. This is inside.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Popped up right side.
Jose Trevino's there.
And it's caught
the out.
First trip to the plate here. That clips the corner. All tied up here in the top of the ninth. And fouled
That's
off.
That's far away. Gosh!
Is that one out of the zone? In there. Fly ball down the line on the move. He's got it. And that is that. So they make short work of back now as they hand the ball to a fresh arm to
number 34.
First and second, one out. Daniel Pryor digging in for the Nationals.
Foul.
The last thing he wants is to hit the ball on the ground, but I wouldn't expect many pitches up in the zone. They'll be pitching for a double play in this spot.
Try to get him to chase on the changeup that time. That's down and in.
Tough spot right here. A couple runners on. Two ball count. You can't nibble, but you have to execute and finish your pitch. If you leave something out over the plate, it's going to bring in some runs.
Yeah, the 2-1 hammered but foul. With the winning run standing at second here in the last half of inning number 9. Ground ball right side could be two. Good to see that double play. And we're headed to extra inning. On to extra innings. Now it's the right fielder, Zidane Rafaela.
Actually, yeah, this is perfect.
And time is called for a mound visit now. Big moment in this game, so they'll talk it over. Back now, we're in extras. And there's a new arm on the mound, Wilmer Flores.
Yeah, this is the other way to make a decision. He's out of options. Oh shit, yeah, I forgot.
Squeeze it. Save the third, moves up on the pass ball.
I forgot about it. All right, we're going to do this.
Now into the ball game on defense, Dalton rushing. He takes over behind the plate. Wouldn't chase that time.
In the infield at the corners, don't be surprised to see them come home first. And prevent that run from scoring.
Mitch misses all three.
You don't want to get beat by a fastball in. And he spits on that one.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Clearly taking all the way there in that 3-0 count. It was a cookie right down the middle.
Bounced out to short.
Grisham comes home and he's out.
Two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of the double play right here.
Down looking.
Strikeout looking. He's got to be frustrated with that call.
Big strikeout right there, and maybe a little controversial with the call. I think he got a little bit of favor on the mound, no question about it. It's not exactly what you want to see in a big spot like that, and I'm sure there's some chirping going on from the dugout, making it clear that wasn't his best call behind the plate today.
Swing and a bouncer, down the line, and it's foul.
If you're a base runner, you got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
Got him! Big strikeout.
Back here in extras.
Strikeout situation right here. Lots of ways for that go-ahead run to score if the ball's put in play.
This ball's chopped to the ground. Whips it across, and there's two away. The tag gets him, and it's a double play to end the inning. Back now, somebody a pinch hitter lead off. Welcome back, and on the mound to start the 11th inning, Owen Murphy. Here comes a pitch. Up, settles under this one, brings it in, and there's one down.
Well, such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ball game and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit, and then from there can really settle in.
Christian Robinson in the box now. Kick strike one. Runner takes off for third. In the air, out towards left center. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. That's out number two. Hunter Coffey getting ready to hit. And the first offering is not close. In the air, right side. Makes a nice running catch. And that, back here at extras, runner at score. Washington, Brady House.
RBI not for him last time. Now a chance to drive in another run.
Going on, Belton.
That ball.
Robinson going back on this one. To the warning track, makes the catch. Runner tagging and heading for home. In comes the winning run, and the Nationals lock it off for the 11th.
Spring training has come to an end. How did Flores do? Pitched one inning, got two strikes. That was his one inning. Can't send down the side. DeAndre Black. Yeah, you get two proven quality starters. Vasho's gonna start the year in Triple A. Yeah, Russian Dilly's gonna start the year in Triple A. Gyro. Actually, yeah, you're gonna have to be in AAA. Same thing with Jameson. Yeah, we can have one more guy up though. Or we can add someone in some. Why the fuck did you bring him back up? What do we need? No. Luis Angel Cunha proved that he could play last year. He proved that he could play last year. So we're gonna play him. Oh, Kelnick's DH, and that's why. Who would I rather have? Yeah, give me Kelnick. He has a stronger arm. I'd rather. Manzardo can. Okay, and rotation. Probably use another reliever. Maybe another lefty. JoJo, $5 million. Yeah, he just signed. Yeah, they're not gonna give him up. Garrett Crochet. He's gonna be a free agent. What would it take? Give you Nunez. And Cliff, yep. Okay, yeah, so. Here is your four roster. It's still a somewhat young roster, but yeah, we can. Still a good, still a young roster. But yeah, I think we should maybe get like the playoffs this year. So you got the Braves in first. Yeah. Yeah, fourth, you got the Dodgers. Ninth, you got the Rays. Seventh, you got Minnesota. Third, you got the Mariners. Second, you got the Rangers. Anyway, that'll do it for this episode. Hope y'all enjoyed it. Have a good one, and I'm out. Bye.